Here's a second version that's considerably simpler than the first version. In the second version, we're simply going to open an existing ProcessBook PDI file, so we don't have to navigate through so many layers. We don't have to find a book and then open an entry and execute it. In this example, I think I'll demonstrate how, if ProcessBook's not running, we'll go ahead and open it. Now, if you notice, it takes a little bit longer this time. And when it finally comes up, now it took longer because ProcessBook was not running. We had to launch it. What this has done is it's gone out and found a specific display called trends, a specific PDI file. Now let's step through the code here and see where there are differences. They're very minor differences. I've got a point right here, breakpoint right here, because pretty much everything above this point is exactly the same thing. We first check with the get object and then the create object. And we really see some differences at this point right here when we say set dis y, which is a display variable, is equal to the result of the open method of not a book but a specific display. And again, we're being prompted, do we want to, or we get to choose whether we want to prompt the user or not to convert if it's an older file format. So the ProcBook's open method can open either PIW files or it can open PDI files as well. Here's an example of how much more direct it is. Now once I've got this dis y, I can use dis y later on as my, this is my display object. I can add symbols, I can add a symbol using the symbols collection of that display object.